So hello everyone, thank you for being here. I'm Benjamin and I'll be the speaker of this presentation. So today I would like to talk about how we hope to bring Zen to the masses with our product called XCPNG. This presentation is in two parts. First, I'll give you a quick history of Vates, the company I'm working at, and its product. And then the core of the presentation will be the second part and how we would like to contribute to Xen and bring Xen to the masses, as the title says. Before I start the presentation, I'd just like to add that we are first-timer at such a Xen event. I came with two colleagues, Ronan and Nicolas, who are here as well. And we are newcomer into the Xen community. We are very excited to be an active part of the Xen community, but we are newcomer, as I said. So this presentation, one of the goals is to make ourselves aware of the community to start exchanging with you. So in the next few days, do not hesitate to come and talk to us. We don't bite, not too often. We are very eager to exchange with you. So let's start with the presentation. As I said, the first part is telling you who are we and what do we do. So first, here I am, very comfortable in front of a camera, as you can see. My name is Benjamin, as I said. I work at Vates, which is a French company, since March. I work on both products, XCPNG and Xen Orchestra, mainly in the networking areas as for now, but it might change in the future. Before working at Vates, I worked in another French company editing VoIP softphone, open source, which was called Linphone. Next to me, you can see Ronan, who came here as well. So if you recognize us in the next few days, come talk to us. We'll be very welcoming. Enough about me. Let's talk about our company, Vates. It is a French company located in Grenoble, France. It was founded by three people, Olivier Lambert, Julien Fontanet, and Nitidia Vial, which are respectively CEO, CTO, and CFO of the company. And it was built around a strong interest in open source solutions. All of our products are open source and libre, and we will continue to do so. Speaking of the products, the first one historically was Xen Orchestra. It is a web UI used to manage, at the time, Xen Server, now called Citrix Hypervisor, and XCPNG after it was created. It has both backup and cloud features, among others, and it is licensed under GPL v2. A little trivia about this product is it was not originally intended to be a commercial product. It was an internal tool used at Vates to manage our customers' environment, but due to a lot of commercial demands, it has been commercialized a few years after its creation. The second product, which is the subject of this presentation, is the XCPNG Hypervisor. It is based on the Xen, the Citrix Hypervisor, and on Xen, obviously. The goal is to make it 100% open source and free, libre. So we are working little by little to remove every closed source components and replace it with our own open source implementations. And we have built a great community around it, very active and growing. We hope to keep it growing in the next years and decades, hopefully. But I will talk a bit more about that in a few slides. So now I'll give you a quick history of Vates and Xen from the point of view of Vates. So let's go back to the dawn of time. The year was 2003, and let there be Xen. And Xen there was. The first ever open source hypervisor. 4 years later, it was XenSource Incorporation was bought by Citrix. It was the birth of Xen Server, which was an hypervisor based on Xen, which was closed source. 3 years later, in 2010, Citrix strategy changed and was more focused on virtualized desktop through its solution Xen App and Xen Desktop. And therefore, if I may say, Xen Server was a bit left behind. So that's why 1 year later appeared XCP, standing for Xen Cloud Platform, which was an open source equivalent of Xen Server. Yes. And 2 years later, in 2013, Xen Server became open source. So it was the end of Xen Cloud Platform, the open source equivalent. And it was also the birth of Xen Orchestra, our first product, the web UI used to manage pools of Xen servers at the time. As I said, it wasn't commercialized at the beginning. The first commercialization of Xen Orchestra was in 2016. In 2017, at the end of the year, December to be more specific, the pricing strategy around Xen Server changed. The free edition itself stripped from some features, which was reserved for a paying edition. And as you might understand, it was a bit of a problem for us since many of our customers and our clients wouldn't want to change to the paying edition of Xen Server because they didn't want to pay for features they used to have for free. And they were considering changing their hypervisor towards, for instance, a KVM or another solution. So we began to think about creating our own hypervisor based on Xen Server, but fully open source and keeping it with all the features for free. To measure the interest for such a solution, we launched a crowdfunding campaign, which was a huge success. It got 50k euros, both from enterprises and private people. And it was more than 700% of the expected goal, so as I said, a huge success. And it confirmed our idea to create XCPNG. So we did it in January of 2018. XCPNG was born from a fork of Xen Server. Now, 18 months later, where do we stand? We believe we have achieved both project and community success. We have launched a forum with more than 500 monthly contributions, more than 1,000 accounts registered, and more than 10,000 posts total. We also include important contribution from the community, patches, for instance, but also fully community-maintained components of XCPNG. A good example of that is the XCPNG Center. It is the XCPNG equivalent of Xen Center, a hard client on Windows used to manage pools of Xen Server or XCPNGs, Citrix hypervisors or XCPNGs. We have more than 25k unique downloads of XCPNG. We have developed an easy process to migrate between Xen Server and XCPNG in order to ease the migration for our customers and to bring the more people we could to use our product. We are a member of the Xen pre-disclosure list in order to maintain the highest security level we can, and by being informed of the security issue before the public knows and fix them before they are divulgated to the public. And we have managed to make a product with no license keys, no restricted features, which means that everything is available for free on XCPNG. And it means also that our only financial incomes from XCPNG is made through support, so people paying to get help from us. We also believe to have achieved the technical success on a few levels. First, we corrected a major bug we inherited from the Xen Server fork. Large disk migration was problematic, for instance. We've launched a test repository for our community to play with the new features we are developing. This enables them to have early access to new features and play with them, as I said. And for us, it is thoroughly tested by the community, and we are more confident into our releases, so a win-win situation. For instance, we have a beta of signed Windows PV drivers to use on Windows. We have added Cloud Stack support. We have added ZSTD compression, which led to huge improvement into massive backup performances. It's 7 times quicker than the old compression we used, which was JZIP. We have upstream contribution in XAPI project and ZFS, for instance. We hope to add Xen project to the list when we will be enough. When we will have learned enough. Sorry, about Xen. I can add a few things from the back of my head. We have removed a few components which were closed source. One using to manage VM migrations called EMU Manager. One to share clipboard between Windows VMs and, for instance, XCP Engine Center, a VNC client, or Xen Orchestra. And we've developed an SDN controller to enable the creation of a private network on a pool scale, which wasn't available only through XAPI and needed to have an external component to do that. So I think, yes, it's the end of the history class. Let's now talk about the future and how we would like to bring Xen to the masses through our XCPNG product and to be an active part of the Xen community. There are many ways we would like to contribute to Xen in the future. I'll briefly recap them with this slide, and then I'll give you more details in the next one. First, we would like to actively participate to the code by providing patches and pull requests when we can and when it's necessary. As I said, it's the reason we're here, to learn as much we can about Xen and to be able to provide a meaningful contribution as soon as possible. We are already collaborating with French universities in Paris, Grenoble, and Nice, which are studying around Xen. We hope to enlarge our contributions to European universities, and why not worldwide universities if we can reach them in the future. We are ready to invest both financial and human resources in Xen by recruiting people into VATES to work on XCPNG and on Xen later. We are also trying to create a rich ecosystem of open source solutions revolving around Xen by doing partnership with open source products. For instance, I can talk about UDS, which has a desktop virtualization solution, which is libre and open source and compatible with our products, and also Linbit, which is a company which work in DRBD and is helping us to develop a new SAN to do hyperconvergence with our product. And by creating a family of open source solutions revolving around Xen, we hope to enlarge the Xen ecosystem of solutions. So a little more detail about our how we would like to contribute technically to Xen. So by doing research and development, we have a few subject and leads we'd like to explore, including network, compute, storage, increasing security and independency of DOM zero. As I said before, we are already collaborating with universities in France, and we hope to enlarge our collaboration to universities all around the world. In fact, what we would like to do is to be a bridge between research results and industry application, because as often, research results can be left to rot in a closet and yet still be very interesting. So what we hope to do is open this closet, find which result might be interesting, and actually use them, yes. We are also ready to financially contribute to the project, firstly by recruiting people in VATES to work actively in XCPNG and therefore around Xen and in Xen when necessary. We are funding university thesis revolving around Xen. We have our first thesaurus coming to work with us in September, working on Xen. Yes, and we would like to continue sponsoring events revolving around Xen, such as this one. We also believe we can be a good contributor with communication by being a showcase of Xen with our product. Firstly, our products never hide the fact that they are based on Xen. They are called Xen Orchestra, and XCPNG stands for Xen Cloud Platform Next Generation. So we are proud to be based on Xen because we think very highly of it, and we do not want to hide it. We try to have as turnkey solution as possible to be really easy to adopt and to use, and to bring the more user we can towards XCPNG and therefore towards Xen. And also, we would like to enter the Linux Foundation as a Xen sub-project to mark our affiliation to Xen. By the way, the only missing thing to enter the Linux Foundation is a sponsor. So if anyone here knows someone or which might be interested or is interested in sponsoring us, I invite you to contact us. I give you contact details at the end of the presentation, or you can come and talk to us during the event. As I said before, we are trying to create a rich ecosystem and of dynamic open source solutions revolving around Xen, and to grow together and to bring the more people we can to use our solutions and Xen. Now, let's be a little more specific about the near future. What we would like to do in the coming years, first, we'd like to increase in firepower. As for now, we are 4 people working full-time on XCPNG. We'd like to bring 2 more people to the team before the end of the year. If possible, people with advanced knowledge. As I said, we are newcomers, so we won't be able to provide patches before we learn everything we can about Xen. Bringing people with already advanced Xen knowledge will enable us to contribute sooner, and also for us beginners to learn from them internally in the company and not only in events like this one. And by the end of 2020, we'd like to be as much as 20 people working on XCPNG and Xen, not only as employees and developers, but also as researchers, collaborators, contractors, etc. So we are open to any means of collaboration between us and the Xen community. As I said, we hope to enter the Linux Foundation as quick as possible. So again, anyone who is interested in sponsoring us, who might know someone, do not hesitate to contact us. And hopefully, we will be able to provide upstream patches, the sooner the better. We are strong believers of upstream contribution because it's a win-win situation. For the external project we are contributing to, it's a way to include the bug fixes or new features, and for every user of the external project to benefit from them. And for us, it allows us to not to have to maintain patches and to differ from the original package. So as I said, it's a win-win situation. We welcome upstream patches into our product, and we try to provide them to each and every one of our own external projects. So I believe this is the end. Yes, this is the end of this presentation. Thank you very much for your attention. You can find contact details here. So again, if you'd like to exchange with us, work with us, or sponsor us for the Linux Foundation, you can reach contact at xcp-ng.org. You are very welcome to come and talk to us in the coming days. And if I have time and there's question, because I have time, I can answer a question if you have any. No, no question? Okay. Ah, yes?
This is going to sound like a very difficult question, but really I'm just curious. So, I mean, the relationship between XCPNG and Kubernetes, shall we say, not entirely easy all the time. I want to know really what proportion you describe it.
Which is it still on? Yes. We really forked Xen server from the source in the beginning. We try not to diverge too much from it in order to be compatible. Oh, I can repeat the question if necessary. No? Okay. But we have our own implementation of the closed source components, for instance. So these are obviously divergence from Xen server. So everything which is closed source will be different in our own product. But yes, we want to continue to contribute to the XAPI project and therefore to Xen server in this in the open source parts of it, and we treat it like an external project for everything we have forked, and we try to replace every closed part by our own diverging open source implementation. I'm not sure I've answered your question or not.
That's great. Thank you. That completely answers my question, and I quite like your answer. Thank you. My boss won't like
thank
that. But.
Anyone else have a question? Okay, well, thank you very much.